Lakas DMD officials welcomed Duterte Carpio to the party. Its president, House Majority Leader Martin Romualdez, said they are honored that Duterte Carpio finally accepted their long-standing invitation to join Lakas CMD. He adds the Davao City Mayor will bear her 2022 plans this weekend.
I'd like to tell you that she has joined the Lakas CMD for a possible run in the national arena of Philippine politics. And the position that she will run for will be known most likely within the weekend. I believe she believes in our way of handling our political endeavors. No? She believes in our vision of nation building and having a very, very positive approach to politics. And so I guess that's what attracted her. And also, as I said, we have a number of leaders, President Ramos, of course, President Lorin Macapagal Arroyo, who has also served not just as president, but as a Speaker of the House of Representatives. And became, Mayor Inday Sara became very close to President Arroyo and became Speaker. So there's been a lot of interaction, no? And a lot of cooperation, no? With our leadership and with Mayor Inday Sara.
An ally of Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio believes she will not agree to a term-sharing agreement should she decide to run and win the presidential elections. Hugpong ng pagbabago Secretary General Anthony Del Rosario calls the proposal to term-share as presidents a very bad idea.
I don't see that happening. That's pure speculation. I don't think Sara will agree to that kind of a setup. Term sharing for presidency, that's a very bad idea. Alam naman natin that a presidency with a term of 6 years is not enough to do the things that you really want to do for this country. So much so if it's only 3 years, diba?
It was Lakas CMD co-chairman, Quezon Governor Danilo Suarez, who said Duterte Carpio and Bongbong Marcos might agree to share the presidency. This after the president's daughter took her oath as a member of Lakas CMD, further boosting speculations she would seek the highest post in the country next year. Prior to her oath-taking, Duterte Carpio resigned from HNP and withdrew her re-election bid. The late dictator's son, Ferdinand Marcos Jr., not backing down from the presidential race. That's amid speculation he may slide down to be Duterte Carpio's running mate.
Examine my situation. I have nowhere else to go. I cannot go anywhere, and I cannot change. I will not change parties. I do not have. I entered this race not to play any of this substitution, play with the rules. I entered this too because I felt I should run for president, and that's what I did.
Unlike Marcos, presidential aspirant Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa says he's willing to withdraw his candidacy for Duterte Carpio. Senator de la Rosa is running under President Rodrigo Duterte's PDP Laban Party.
Lahat ay naghihintay sa moves niya. Ano yung magiging move niya? Everything will adjust. Ang presidente ang tatakbuhan niya. Granting na tatakbo siya under another party, not with PDP Laban. So, andyan pa rin ako as standard bearer ng PDP Laban. Ang gagawin ko is sabi ko si Pangulong Duterte na with all due respect, mag-withdraw ako.
A former elections commissioner sees red flags in the possible team-up of prominent politicians in the upcoming elections. Attorney Christian Monsod fears the 2022 bids of several administration forces is not just a way for President Duterte to evade accountability over a wide range of issues. He believes it's also a way for them to tighten their grip on power.
It looks like there is a plan beyond just accountability. It's to consolidate power. consolidate total power in a coalition that brings together the Marcoses, the Romualdeses, the Arroyos, and the Dutertes. And if they can pull it through, we will really have authoritarianism. Now they're dropping the idea of the president running for Senate and becoming Senate president. And we already have heard about Arroyo becoming Speaker of the House. So you have a Marcos as president and a Duterte as vice president. That completes the picture of four political dynasties that covers the entire Philippines.
So that's
the frightening thought that we should think about. If they're together in a total power coalition, they will know how to divide the power to stay forever.
The Philippine Commission on Elections issues a summons to presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos. That's over a petition filed by several civic groups seeking to nullify his certificate of candidacy. Marcos has 5 days to answer the summons. That petition, which centers on Marcos's 1995 tax conviction, is being handled by COMELEC's 2nd Division. Another group composed of 10 professionals has also sought to block Marcos's presidential candidacy. A political analyst believes there's still a possibility that Sara Duterte and Bongbong Marcos can come up with a deal wherein only one of them runs for president, but both of them come out as winners in the end. Professor Edna Co of the University of the Philippines says it's now up to voters to make sure the Filipino people doesn't end up in the losing end of the stick.
In politics, many things can be negotiated, and maybe there are already ongoing negotiations that in the end, some people will really be winners. What happens will also trigger a lot of discernment on the part of voters because they belong to a similar or friendly camps. They will have to also carry on with the agenda, and not much change can be expected. If there is no sufficient change that we could see, it's really more a loss for the Filipino public and for the voters.